Denzel with the Realest Team, Sean Trail, you already know the channel, The Realest Physiques. And guess what, man? I checked my email today, and I was shocked to find out that I did not get any sponsorships. So, I'm not going to say I was shocked, but I kind of expected that. No sponsorship, but today, I want to do a review on Quest Bars, man. This is the cookie dough flavor. I had the cookie and cream yesterday. I do not usually eat protein bars, I'm not gonna lie, but you know there's a big craze going on about Quest bars, so I figured why not jump on board and give my review from a non-biased opinion, and also someone who really doesn't care about protein bars, and also someone who is so new. Yeah, there's no chance I'll be getting an endorsement, so stay tuned for the protein bar review. In this review, I'm gonna be giving this a rating of 1 through 10 on three topics. Three topics are gonna be, for one, ingredient, price, and flavor. So let me go ahead and open this thing up, man. I had the Oreo one yesterday. Not gonna lie, probably one of the best. I'm not gonna say the best, but one of the best flavored protein bars I've ever had. Keep in mind, guys, how many times I gotta say, I don't eat protein bars, so that kind of hinders the results, I guess. But see how this tastes. On a scale of 1 through 10, from the protein bars I had, I would definitely give this at least an 8. Reason being, right away, first thing I was looking for was like, you know, the nasty aftertaste or the taste that hits your tongue right away. This does not have that. Right when you bite into this, you taste cookie dough, which is pretty solid, man. Everyone talks about the cookie and cream being the best, but I don't know, this one is pretty solid. As far as ingredients, it doesn't have many ingredients, so that makes me feel really confident in this protein bar. Number one ingredient is the protein blend of whey protein isolate and milk protein isolate. That is what I like to see. I do not see anything to do with soy ingredients. A lot of times when you go to like Walmart, you know, Target, you see protein bars that are overpriced and you look for the ingredients and the first thing you see is soy protein. But this actually, first ingredient is whey protein, so that means I would definitely give that a 10. A 10 out of 10 for not seeing soy. If you're vegan, I don't care. This is not soy. So this is whey. Sucks to be a vegan, but ingredients on this are really nice. So we got the protein, that's it. You got prebiotic fiber, almonds, water, unsweetened chocolate, cocoa butter, and a few other things. They got stevia on this, natural flavors. But first thing I noticed when I picked this bar up was 21 grams of protein, 1 gram of sugar. I don't know how they do it, how it tastes really good, 1 gram of sugar, but some, I guess they figured out a way. This bar has 17 grams of fiber and is gluten-free. One thing I want to say about the 17 grams of fiber. If you're a bodybuilder like me who takes nutrition very serious, without eating protein of any kind, you're already getting roughly 30 grams of fiber from eating whole foods. One bad thing I want to say about this protein bar. People are saying, oh my gosh, I love these bars because they have 17 grams of fiber. I see people on YouTube who, you know, eat this bar like with every meal. And it's kind of ridiculous in my opinion. So an average day for me without this protein bar, through Whole Foods, I get about 30 grams of fiber on average. So say I throw in one of these protein bars, these Quest bars, bump that up another 17 grams of fiber. Let me tell you, from the cookie and cream one I had yesterday, I'm not gonna lie. Sorry to gross you guys out, but when I sat on the toilet today, I had that urge. You know when you get that urge, you know you have to go to the bathroom, right? It's natural for everybody. So I sat down and I noticed something was wrong back there. So I'm a little nervous about eating this, not gonna lie. It's really good, has some really good ingredients. But if I could give Quest, you know, a hint on what I think would help, cut the fiber in half. I would definitely cut it in half. 17 grams of fiber for a protein bar is a lot. You do not need 17 grams of fiber unless you are I guess, not eating whole foods. But if you're a bodybuilder, you should definitely be eating whole foods. So they should have no problem getting fiber in. I don't get how people and other YouTubers always say, oh, take this in so I can get my fiber. What are you eating? Are you not eating, you know, whole foods, beans and all that good carbohydrates? So, Quest, if any of you guys ever see this video, make some of these Quest bars with less fiber. That's for sure. No, that is probably one of the only bad things I would say about this bar. If you look at it, it has an appealing look. The size is just right. The texture is consistent. It's not leaving you with a chalky aftertaste in your mouth. Nothing like that. So, price-wise, price is next, man. I bought this from a gas station. Keep in mind, the gas station price is marked up even more, but this was $2.99. $2.99 for a protein bar, you know what? No, I wouldn't normally buy this. I would just get me some chicken breasts. You can get, you know, a pound of chicken breasts, chicken thighs for like $1.99, you know, uncut, and, you know, you just cut them up and save money. But as far as price, I'm not gonna lie, man, these are kind of ridiculous, at least at the gas station. I see them online for like an average of $2, which is still, in my opinion, kind of high, considering that it is basically a lot of fiber. A lot of the protein is coming from the fiber source. That's why it's high fiber, I'd like to think. So, you guys don't really think about that, you know what I'm saying. But, along with cutting the fiber in half, I would definitely ask them to, you know, chop the price down. I'm not going to say in half, because that would be only in a dream world. But, you know, mark it down 25%. So it can be more affordable. So as far as taste, I said an 8. As far as ingredients, I'm gonna give that a 10. Actually, I'm gonna give it a 9, just because of that high fiber. And as far as pricing, it is about a 7. So that concludes this video. I'm gonna finish this Quest bar, man. I might let you guys know in the next video if how the next day of using the bathroom goes, because I'm actually pretty scared. But I kind of managed my micro so that my fiber was low for the day, so I could have room for this. That concludes the video, guys. If you like the video, like it. If you dislike it, like it anyways. Comment, subscribe, share. If you have any hints or tips for me, feel free to let me know. You guys have a blessed day and stay real, man. Peace out.